Hey, what's up guys? This is the Toptro X1. It's a brand new LED projector for your home cinema needs. I'm pretty excited. It is 1080p by native design, but you can upscale to 4K. I'm gonna go ahead and unbox this. There's so many cool features. It's Wi-Fi compatible. It's got Bluetooth inbuilt into it. And you can set it up with four-dimensional keystone correction, which I'm going to showcase. Let me go ahead and open it up, set everything here, and I'm going to project it onto the wall behind me. So let's get straight into it. You get this really nice portable carry case. So there you have the projector. I really like the space gray design, but I'll showcase that more in a second. In the box, you have yourself a HDMI cable. So you've got a really large user manual, the power plug as well. You've got the audio video cable if you wanted to connect it using that, a cleaning cloth for the bulb, and then finally a remote control. So let me open this up just to showcase to you guys what buttons you get with this. So the pretty standard ones, you have your directional menu buttons with OK, which also is a play and pause button. You got the source, you have a maybe orientation button there to switch between flipping the video horizontally or vertically. Then you got the home button, back, forward, rewind, the volume buttons, mute button, and the power. So pretty standard, requires two AAA batteries, so I'm going to use this to control the projector. Let's open this and take a look at that. Now, I really like this fabric design at the top. You've got some buttons here, and this is actually pressable, so each of these is a little button underneath the fabric. When I turn this on, you'll be able to see there's a little light that will come on there inside that little strip. So on the front, you've got the bulb cap there. If you take that off, it's just a twist and it's recessed into the actual projector. At the bottom, you have yourself the screw stand. So if you unscrew this, you can adjust the elevated height of the projector as well. On the left-hand side, this is where you have the focus wheel to make sure the screen is in focus. You have fans on both sides as well. Now at the back, you have yourself two USB ports, a headphone port, the AV port, two HDMI ones, and the power supply goes in there. So let's go ahead, set this up, run through a little bit more about the specs on this, and let's test it out on the wall. So to turn it on, you simply press the power button once, and you can see it starts up pretty quickly. The one other thing I like about it, it's actually not so loud. A lot of projectors I've had in the past, there's a lot of fan noise coming from it. This is relatively so much more silent than the other ones that I've had, which I think is great. Right, so I've just set it up. I've mounted it onto my chair. I've put a little box underneath just to give it a little bit of elevation. As you can see, by default, it's a little bit blurry, so I'm just gonna adjust the focus wheel to get that into a readable position. There we go. It's very clear. Now, at the moment, I do have a couple of studio lights on here as well, so I will be turning that off, and I will get very dark just so you guys can see the screen a little bit more. But the one thing I really wanted to showcase to you before I do that is the four-dimensional keystone correction. So before I even start using this, I'd like to align it and position it in a perfect rectangle so that I can get my perfect viewing experience with this. So to do that, use the remote control, go into settings on the top right hand side, go into projection image setting, then you have something there called four-point keystone. If you go into that, you'll see there's a green dot on each corner of the screen there as well. So all I have to do is use the remote control to adjust that down and right, and this will change the entire projection. So I'm bringing it a little bit forward from that side. If I press OK, I move to the next corner, I adjust that, and you can see it's bringing it a little bit forward. So a lot of the projectors I've had in the past, you're only able to adjust on the X and Y axis. This brings it along the Z axis as well, which I think is great. And this really makes it easier for various different room sizes. So if you're in awkward positions or the projector is a little bit too low and you can't get the right angle, this would allow you to do that. So I'm really impressed with that. The one thing I can do is connect it to Wi-Fi. You can also connect it to Bluetooth. The thing about the Bluetooth is that you can also use an external Bluetooth speaker, or you can use Bluetooth headphones to listen to everything that's playing on the projector. Now, this is really convenient because a lot of projectors might not have great audio inbuilt into it, but I will be testing the audio on this by playing a sample video for you guys just to see how it comes out in terms of the sound. But usually with things like this, I would recommend setting it up with Bluetooth, have a nice speaker system around, and then you really have a home cinema system. So let me go ahead, connect it to Wi-Fi, and I'll showcase to you guys connecting it using my HDMI cable and my MacBook, and also put in a USB as well. Because one thing I also like in this also comes with Office Suite capabilities inbuilt. Now what that means is once you have a USB which has Microsoft Office files already on there, or even just PDF files, it will automatically detect it and you can start playing it directly straight away with no problems whatsoever. So if you're doing presentations, this is perfect for work, and I will showcase a PowerPoint presentation that I've got on my USB disk and play it directly onto this as well. So let me go ahead, connect to the Wi-Fi, and I'll showcase to you some of those examples. All right guys, so I've turned off all of the lights so you can see how bright this is. Now the brightness on this is 7500 lumens, which I think is absolutely great, and there's a contrast ratio of 10,000 to 1. Now I'm going to go ahead and plug in this USB into the projector, and each of the four categories that you see here, movie, music, photo or office suite, you'll need to insert a USB to play one of them. One other thing I really like is that you can cast and screen mirror your iPhone or an Android phone as well using Miracast. So I'll showcase to you guys doing that with my iPhone 12 Pro shortly after this. So I'm gonna go ahead, stick the USB into the USB port at the back. There we go, I've just connected it. So now you can see on the top right hand corner of the screen, the USB icon has now lit up, which shows it's ready to play either one of these categories. So let me go ahead and first of all, connect to the office suite, which is what I was explaining earlier. Go into USB, and then I will be able to play my presentation. So it's loading up the office suite inbuilt into this. All right, so it's opened it. I'm going to the menu and start slideshow. So there you have it. I've got this template I've just downloaded online. So now I can just use the buttons on the remote control and run through my presentation. But as you can see, it's very clear. I can read all of the text. There's nothing that's blurry. And to be honest, the animations look really smooth in this as well. So as I'm cycling through, I think it's just doing a great job, and I can use this for multiple different purposes for my workplace. Now, one thing is that this has a white background, so I wanted to do a comparison of a dark imaged based slideshow. So let me go ahead and open the next one, which I have as a template, to see how that performs in low lighting conditions like here, where I've turned off all the lights. So now I'm just opening my dark version. Okay, there we go. It's got a very dark navy blue background, but as you can see, it's still clear. You might not be able to see 100% of what I see based on the video recording. However, when I'm standing near it, and if anyone else was in the room, you'd still be able to read everything. You can see all the icons, the images, and I think it just really stands out. So the brightness on this amongst the resolution, I think it just does a great job in displaying it onto a wall, which is in dark environments. So now let me play a video file to see the video quality and the audio quality coming from the speaker itself. And I have this trailer, so let's play this. And I will put the volume up from the projector. So let's go a little bit louder. So I'm just going to pause it there, guys. As you can see, it's pretty punchy. I really like the audio coming from this because it's loud enough where you might not even need an external speaker, especially a Bluetooth one. Even though I didn't even go to 100%, it was on 60 and I could still hear this very clearly. Now, just as another example, what I'm going to do is connect this to my laptop via the HDMI cable rather than the USB. All right, guys, so now I've connected it using the HDMI port to my MacBook Pro. As you can see, this is the Amazon listing. It's pretty responsive. It's almost real time. And you can also use this to extend the displays instead of just mirroring the displays. So I'm just mirroring it at the moment. This is the Amazon page for this projector. The link is in the description down below of this page as well if you guys wanted to check it out. These are the key specs which I will be covering. One thing to note is that you can go up to a maximum of 350 inches for the projection size. So if you have a large enough space that's that big, it is absolutely possible. The recommendation for the ideal amount is 120 inch. What I'm currently displaying is around 75 inches, which is still looks great in this little office room that I have. The lamp life is 150,000 hours, which is great, and it's probably one of the largest that I've seen. To be honest, the design and all of the functionalities of this projector, I think it's probably one of the best on Amazon, in my honest opinion. So definitely check it out. In terms of everything else, you can also open up Netflix. So let me do that. So you can use this to watch movies. If you have any of the on-demand services, pretty much it will do an excellent job. Let's play an example movie. So the volume currently is coming from my MacBook Pro because that's the audio output that's set in the settings. So I can change that if I wanted to come out of the projector, or I can just connect my MacBook to another external speaker and play it through that. So as you can see, it's pretty great quality. I may use this as a home cinema projector in one of my rooms in my house and just watch movies on it at night times. I think that will be the best scenario for me, but there's so many different uses for this. Now, one other use that I really like about it is the phone mirroring. So if I'm going to set up my iPhone 12 Pro with the iOS cast on this, I can show quickly some of the photos I've taken, some of the videos I've taken from my phone directly onto the projector if I have family or friends coming around. So let me show you how I can do that. So as I was pointing out earlier, you have this option here called iOS cast. If you select this, make sure you're on the Wi-Fi connected both for your phone and the projector. Then all you need to do is go into the screen mirroring option of your iPhone. So I've got my iPhone here. If I type in the screen mirroring, it will appear on the options list. You'll see the name of the projector. So all you have to do is select that and it will start mirroring. Right, there we go. I've got it on my iPhone as well. So just to showcase to you guys how responsive it is, you can see like that. Again, you can use this to go through some images. You can play some videos, whatever you like to do. It's pretty endless. So for example, if I open up the YouTube app, let's play one of my videos. Before I continue, just by default, once I've opened a YouTube video, it went into landscape full screen mode on the actual projector. And the phone itself is just as it is when you're using it. This is the phone and everything is just as it is, but it's playing by expanding the video playback on the projector so you can use the phone as a remote control. So let me go ahead and play this. It doesn't even make sense what I think about you. It was only one. Now I'm just gonna put the volume down a little bit. What I wanted to highlight is this is a very dark video and I can still see a lot of the blacks. The details in it is so crystal clear. One thing I've noticed is with some projectors I've had in the past, it's sometimes hard to see the deep shadows, the contrast and the sharpness in the colors, but it still remains quite vibrant. And I feel like this is the perfect solution for watching videos, especially in nighttime conditions. If you have a slightly darker wall, this might make it a little bit difficult. However, for the most part, you're gonna project this onto a light wall or a white screen that you can buy externally, and it will do a great job. So I'm pretty impressed with that. So that's all of the different use cases that I really wanted to highlight. Alright guys, so that was a review. Hopefully you found that useful. I'm really happy with this. The quality is great. It's probably one of the best that I've seen available on Amazon. It costs £230, but check out the link in the description below. They may have some offers running throughout the year as well, so you can grab yourself a great deal. I'm so happy with this. There's so many different things that I can use it for. Specifically, I'm gonna set up a home cinema room and use this for that. So mixed with the design, which I think looks great, the low amount of heat that is dispersed from this as well, and the very low noise decibels coming from this as well, I think those combinations, in addition to all of the features that this is packed with, makes it a great purchase. If there's anything else you guys want to know about this projector, then drop a comment down below. Otherwise, I hope you subscribe. I hope you like this video. I'll catch you guys at the next one. Take care.